हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम इन द केमिस्ट्री ऑनलाइन क्लास. इन टुडेज क्लास आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द चैप्टर 5 लैंग्वेज ऑफ केमिस्ट्री. इन टुडेज पार्ट यू विल स्टडी अबाउट केमिकल सिंबल्स ऑफ एलिमेंट्स, वैलेंसी, वेरिएबल वैलेंसी एंड रेडिकल्स. सो लेट्स सी द फर्स्ट टॉपिक, द chemical symbols of an element. Students, before the starting the topic symbol, I want to ask one question, that when we talk about oxygen, hydrogen, the first thing what comes in your mind? Very obvious, the symbol, that is O for oxygen and H for hydrogen. So now we can say the symbol, a symbol is the shorthand representation for the atom of a specific element, and each chemical element has its own unique symbol. So now the question arises, why these symbols are needed? These symbols are needed when the more elements were discovered. The need for this symbolic representation for these elements became more evident in order to recognize them or in order to use them in chemistry. It's important to use some symbols. In the 19th century, a Swedish chemist, Jacob Berzelius, systematically assigned the first letter of name in capital as the symbol of elements. And this, for an example, O for oxygen, H for hydrogen, and so on. And this was very soon accepted by chemists everywhere. And later, the same is accepted by IUPAC, and it is formed a system of chemical symbols and formulae. Now, how symbols, as I said, for a symbol of a chemical element, the first letter is utilized as a symbol and it is always written as a capital letter. And the second letter, if the symbol contains two letters, then the second letter will be as a small letter. For an example, for hydrogen, it's H, and for helium, the two letters are there. H is capital and E is small. Some symbols are taken from the names of elements in Latin, German or Greek. Example, symbol of iron is Fe and its Latin name is ferrum. So symbol of iron is taken from ferrum, that is Fe. Now, how to write symbols? The two very important rules we should follow while writing the symbols of elements. First one, if an element has a symbol of a single letter, then it should always be written in a capital letter. For an example, N for nitrogen, not small n. You will write capital N. Similarly, if there are two letters in the element symbol, then the second letter is always a small letter. For an example, for cobalt, it's capital C and small O. Not both the letters will be in capital. This is wrong. The correct one is capital C and small O. Now the some symbols you can see here, and this table is also given in your book. See, aluminium, for aluminium it's Al, for calcium Ca, for copper Cu, for iron Fe. See here students, calcium and copper both begins with letter C. So in order to avoid the confusion, the second letter has been utilized as a symbol. For calcium it's Ca and for copper it's Cu. Similarly, for magnesium, it's Mg. For mercury, it's Hg. For potassium, K. And so on. Now, the next topic is valency. Valency is the combining capacity of an atom, of an element or of a radical with the atoms of other elements or radicals to form molecules. In short, the combining capacity of an atom is called valency, and this combining capacity depends upon the electrons which are present in the valence shell of an atom. For an example, valency of hydrogen is taken as 1, and when there will be a compound formation between hydrogen and chlorine, means hydrogen chloride molecule, that is HCl, then one atom of chlorine combines with one atom of hydrogen. So the valency of, see in the formula itself, one hydrogen atom combines with one chlorine atom. So for hydrogen, its valency will be 1, and similarly for chlorine also its valency will be 1. In another example, in water molecule H2O, one atom of oxygen combines with two atom of hydrogen. So the valency of oxygen will be 2. In next example, ammonia, that is NH3, one atom of nitrogen combines with three atoms of hydrogen. You can see in the formula NH3, one nitrogen atom combines with three hydrogen atom. So the valency of nitrogen will be 3, and for hydrogen the valency will be 1. In a methane, the CH4 molecule, from the formula itself you can identify the valency. The carbon atom combines with 4 hydrogen atom, so the valency of carbon will be 4. It is noticed that the valency of elements increases from 1 to 4 and then again decreases to 1. You can see in the next table the valency. Here, see students, valency increases 1 to 4 and then it is start decreasing to 1. And for inert gases, for like helium, neon and argon, their valency is 0. And this sequence is always repeated after a certain interval. You can see here 1, 2, 3, 4. Then valency starts decreasing 3, 2, 1, then 0. Then again starts increasing 1, 2, 3, 4. So we can say the valency of elements increases from 1 to 4 and then again it decreases to 1. The next is variable valency. Certain elements exhibit more than one valency. That means they show variable valency. For an example, copper. Copper has two valency, that is 1 and 2. You can see in the table, the lower valency state, that is plus 1, when copper shows plus 1 valency, means plus 1, then us is being added in the word, that is cuprous. And when it shows plus 2 valency, means higher valency, then suffix is added, that is cupric. In the same way for iron, symbol is Fe, and it shows 2 valency, 2 and 3. And for Fe2+, it is written as ferrous, and if iron shows plus 3 valency, then its name will be ferric. Similarly with lead, plus 2 valency and plus 4 valency. When it shows plus 2, it's plumbus, and when it shows plus 4 valency, plumbic. Once again, I am saying, students, valency always depends upon the valence electrons, means the electrons which are present in the last shell of an atom. Or we can say the valency depends upon the electrons which are being shared in between two atoms during a chemical reaction. Now the next is radicals. A radical is an atom of an element or a group of atoms of different elements that behaves as a single unit with a positive or negative charge. It is of two types, basic radical. They have a positive charge and are also called as cations. And the next is acid radicals. They have negative charge and are also called anions. Now see, students, a molecule of a compound is always made up of two parts. That is, one is a positive charge part and another one is a negative charge part. For an example of sodium chloride, then sodium ion is positively charged while the chloride ion is negatively charged. And it is represented as Na plus and Cl minus respectively. And the charges on these radicals show there the combining capacity, that is a valency. Now see, in this table, you can see here the valency and symbols of some common cations, means positive radicals are here. That can be monovalent, means only one charge will be there, only plus one charge, Na plus, K plus, Cu plus. And bivalent means they contains 2 plus charge, Mg2 plus, Ca2 plus, Zn2 plus, Cu2 plus, Ni2 plus. And for trivalent, it will be plus 3 charge, Al3 plus for aluminium, Fe3 plus for ferric, and Cr3 plus for chromium. Same for tetravalent, that is when they contains 4 plus charge. And some negative radicals, you can see monovalent, there is also three types: monovalent, bivalent and trivalent. For monovalent, it will be minus 1, means 1 negative charge, Cl minus, Br minus, I minus, OH minus. So these are the negative radicals, contains minus 1 charge. For bivalent, it contains 2 minus charge, O2 minus, S2 minus, sulfite. And see, students, radical, as I definition says, that radical, it is a group of atoms. It is an atom of an element or a group of atom of different elements. So I want to show you this. For an example, NO2 minus, that is nitride ion. NO2 minus means nitride ion is it is composed of nitrogen and oxygen, and this minus charge is for both, for nitrogen and for oxygen both. So this NO2 minus, it behaves like a single unit, and whenever this combines with any other atom, the whole, this NO2 whole molecule will, this whole part is going to combine with the another atom or radical, not single, means no nitrogen cannot combine with that, nor oxygen is going to combine with that atom. Means this whole is going to combine with that atom. Similarly, for HCO3 minus, means this whole as a single unit will combine with another atom, not single unit, means not hydrogen, carbon and oxygen as a singly, no one, as an independent unit, no one will combine. As a whole, it will combine with another atom or radical. For more detail, just go through your textbook. Today's homework: define symbols of an element. Question number 2, what is valency? Give an example. Question number 3, what is variable valency? Give two examples of elements showing variable valency. Question number 4, explain the two types of radicals with